Welcome back there, boys and girls. It's time for our dissection slides in the flipping the class. This video we'll be talking about Squid Billy. Here's a picture of a squid, I think. Looks pretty squid-like anyway. So, as always, you've got the squid and its squid parts up here. This is actually posterior. Well, and a squid's kind of weird. Posterior end is sort of right here. Near the siphon, and the anterior and the mouth is actually right in there, but their body sort of squiggles and jiggles up and back down. So that part's a little tricky. What is easy to tell though is dorsal and ventral side. So the dorsal side will be this side that's top right here. The ventral side will be the side with the siphon on it. So again, before you cut open the squid, check out his external features. You're gonna make a little sketchy doodle of it. Check out the fin. Feel how rugged the mantle is. Look for the siphon versus the pen. Try to feel up in there for the mouth parts. Check out the arms and the tentacles and the usual whatnot features. Here's a picture of the squid. This is dorsal side up. You'll see right here, this is actually the pen, which is a nice supportive like backbone type structure. And then you should be able to see the eyes and the mantle and the whatnot on the outside. This is not the side that you're going to cut. If you have the pen side, you need to flip it over. The pen's nice and hard, and that should be on the bottom when you're dissecting.
Your squid here is upside down. You want to get the, well, not quite. It's kind of twisted. You want the funnel here. You want this part right here like this. So yours is kind of mashed to the side. So you did a good job having the funnel up, pen down, but yours is kind of twisted here. And you don't want to pin it just yet. It's going to take two hands. See how the scissors have a big end and a little end?
Yeah.
Put the little end underneath.
All right.
Yeah, and stick it in there nice and horizontal and pull up a little bit on the collar. Yeah, just like that.
Not cutting.
You're doing great. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, perfect. You're doing great.
Wow. This is crazy.
That is excellent.
So you open it up and it should look like this. The cut is pretty straightforward. Just have it with the siphon side up and make your cut straight up to the top using the scissors. Then use the pins here to get a good pinning of the mantle out of the way. You need to make sure this pin in there not so good. This pin, I'm not even sure why that one's there. This one though looks pretty good like this. You want to make sure that your pin heads are really out at a nice extreme angle. That way it is all out of your way.
If this thing is rubbery, that's what you meant. And here's so that's what you meant by extreme angles.
And even more extreme, let me see one of those pins.
Like basically sideways?
Yeah, so you take this pin and pretty much sideways you can actually stab it through the rubber.
But here's a picture of the squid. You should be able to see the gills on the inside there. Here's the pen. Underneath all that, you're going to rip that out with a pair of forceps, and bonus points, anybody that gets it out whole, you may be a surgeon later. There's the face. Here is the siphon down here. You should be able to see the intestine and the anus pointing straight into the siphon so that they can get rid of waste really nice and easily. And this push off to the side, that's the cecum. And other structures like at the top here next to the gills, you'll find the hearts and stuff like that. It's all on your diagram. It shouldn't be too bad. Here's one with it labeled. Squid are kind of weird. They've got two brachial gill hearts, and they also have a systematic heart in the middle that's really difficult to find. Don't worry if you don't find that. You should see the ink sac with the intestine right next to it. Eyeballs, that's actually a stomach, and the stomach is sort of combined with this really cool thing called the cecum, which is like a weird hybrid stomach intestine, like liquid absorber type thing. Here's a diagram showing that. Thanks for watching.